just let the wheel do all the work.
Yeah. But there's somebody like me in charge.
It's a song.
So we start putting the pressure on it and get it centered. And it starts twisting. It's more or less anchored to the piece. So I'm going to start trying to comb this up, and that's really going to twist those colors together all as one.
And is this going to end up like a piece?
More or less like that, yeah.
Okay.
Just under the surface.
Yeah.
So it's really nice.
That's amazing.
And that's going on inside every single piece of pottery in some way, shape, or form. So we're going to take it on back down. Most potters would stop about here and open up the ball because I really want to move those colors together. I'm just going to flatten the whole piece out. And I do this for every single piece, no matter whether it's a tall piece, short piece. So I'm not a pain in the butt, but it changes things a little bit and gives me a result. So let's push that ball right back up again. And in essence, I've inverted that cone now. So that spiral you saw on the outside is now on the inside.
And where do you get your clay?
Starworks, right down the road.
Is it all sourced from?
Some of it is local clay. There's no white clay local in Seagrove, so I ship that in. That's from Asheville.
But it's all from North Carolina?
No, the dark brown clay is not from North Carolina. I think that's from Ohio. I'm actually not sure where standard clay is located, but I'm pretty sure there's somewhere in there from Ohio. I figured that would add more richness a little bit.
Tammy said your family has done this for a long time with this technique?
Dad showed me this technique pretty early on. It is a few centuries old. We'll find examples of it in India, in England, and